So now, mga Lodi, we'll discuss kung ano yung Caltech naman for homogeneous equations saka variables sa parabol. Or I think applicable tong method na to for most types of equations na lumalabas sa board exam. So, meron tayong examples dito na merong answer key. So, ito try natin yan. So, ito yung pinaka-process talaga. First, we have a term containing the x. Now, that will correspond to u. So, u is the term containing the x. And then, v naman is the term containing dy sa original equation natin. So, for this one, number one, we have dy over dx equals 4y divided by x times y minus 3. So, type natin yan. Eto. Then, 4y divided by x times y minus 3. Now, diba, this is variable separable kasi we can multiply x sa kabilang side and then we can multiply the reciprocal of this expression 4y divided by y minus 3 dyan sa dy such that we have y minus 3 divided by 4y dy equals x divided by dx divided by x. Yan. Now, first, ito yung consideration natin. The form of the equation must be the term containing dx plus the term containing dy. Set natin yan to 0. So, ito yung mangyayari. We have, move natin yan sa kabilang side ng equation, it will be minus. So, minus dx divided by x. And then, plus ito. So, copy ko na lang. Ayan. So, equal yan to 0. Again, our form must be, sulat ko na lang. Bale, u dx plus v dy must be equal to 0. Ayan. So, this is our first consideration. Now, we can rewrite this para mas makita natin, diba? This is 1 over x, negative 1 over x dx. Then, copy ko na lang yan. Yan. So again, the term containing dx, that is u. Yan. So this is u pala. And then, the term containing dy is v. Ayan. Now, ito yung first natin gagawin. Sa calculator mo, whatever the value of x is, yan din yung input value natin for y. Para madali yung equation natin. And then, whatever the value of x and y is, yan din yung ipa-plug natin sa ddx na calculator natin. Sa isi-set nating value for the, anong tawag dito? Yung derivative. So, una talaga, input x and y sa calculator mo. So, eto. Recall, kano na lang yung gagamitin ko. Yan. So, input x, so alpha x, then alpha y. After which, press calc, and then input ka ng, usually 3 yung ginagamit ko. So, 3, and then 3 din for y. Yan. So, nakastore na yan. Pag i-recall natin si x, 3 yan. And then, y naman is 3. Ayan. So, gagawin natin dito. Again ha, sinet ko yung x to 3. Yung y din. Sinet ko to 3. So, ito yung form natin. We must get the value of negative u multiplied by v to the negative 1. Yan. So, isustore ko yan sa letter A. Yan. So, negative u. What is u? Diba, the term containing the x. So, negative 1 over x. Now, merong minus dyan. So, minus, then u natin is negative 1 divided by x. Yan. Then, we have to multiply that by v to the negative 1. Now, what is v? Diba, v is this expression. Y minus 3. Ayan. Wait lang. Eto. So, y minus 3 divided by 4y. Yan. And then, to the negative 1. Ito pala. Para mas madali. Yan. So, press equals. Nag-math error siya. So, yung gagawin mo, pag mag-math error siya, just replace the value of x and y. So, press calc. Yan. Instead of 3, try daw natin. 2. And then, yung y then 2. So, diba, meron ang value na lalabas. So, trial and error lang talaga yung value na isa-set mo for x and y. So, again, hindi siya nag-work sa 3. So, gagawin natin 2. Ayan. So, yung lumabas na value is negative 4. Ayan. So, I will store that sa A. But, pwede mo nang hindi yan i-store kasi negative 4 lang naman. Madali lang i-recall. Now, ano yung next na gagawin? Next natin gagawin, di ba, pag merong choices yung exam, or pag meron ka ng answer and then you just want to check if tama yung sagot mo, then meron ka ng expression na to. Now, sa solution natin, dapat ito yung form. C must be on the other side of the equation. And then equal to a certain function. So, di ba, this is the solution to number 1. So, x to the 4th y cubed equals ce to the y. Ayan. Now, c must be, siya lang isa sa isang side ng equation. So, to simplify this, we can divide both sides by e to the y. So, dividing both sides, magiging x to the 4th, then y cubed divided by e to the y equals c. Diba? Now, once naset na natin yung c sa kabilang side and then meron tayong function dyan, itong function na to, idadaan natin sa dy over dx or yung derivative sa calculator natin. Yan. So, ito, idadaan natin sa d dx kung ano yung expression dyan. But, take note na we have to first solve the normal. So, the equation as it is, this one. Yan. And then, we also have to store the d dx, yan, of the interchanged variables. Now, medyo mahirap to at first, but pag nagamay mo na, madali na lang siya i-follow. So, again, normal tas interchanged. So, yung sa normal, we have d dx, and then ito yung normal function. Ayan. So, copy ko. Itatype natin siya. Then, x must be equal to kung ano yung nandito. So, diba, 2 yung ginamit natin. So, 2. Ayan. And then, for the interchange function, papalitan, i-interchange lang natin si y saka x. So, eto, we have d dx, and then yung x, papalitan natin ng y. So, parang y to the 4th. Yung y naman, papalitan natin ng x. So, x cubed divided by e to the x na din yan. Kasi e to the y, again, lahat ng variables y, papalitan ng x. Lahat ng x, papalitan ng y. Yan. And then, we have to set this x equals 2. Ayan. Now, press shift and then this symbol. Yan. So, ito yung first natin itatype. So, x to the 4th then multiplied by y cubed divided by e to the y. Ayan. Then, x equals 2. So, press equals, we have this value. Ayan. So, I will store this sa letter B. Ayan. Lagay ko, ha? Lalagay ko sa B. Color red na lang. Ayan. And then, ito naman, yung interchange variables, just press up para you will be directed here. And then, papalitan lang natin yung x. Gawin natin y. Then, ito magiging x. Saka, ito rin, magiging x. So, press equals, we have this value. So, store natin yan sa C. Ayan. So, nasa C yan. Now, di ba, we have this expression, negative u times v to the negative 1. Now, itong b, yan yung mag-a-act as u. Itong c naman, yan yung mag-a-act as v. Therefore, if we will get the value of negative b, yan, multiplied by c to the negative 1, then we must have the same expression as this, given na tama yung solution natin, or tama yung sagot natin. So, itatype lang natin yan. We have negative b, recall b, yan, then multiplied by c, eto, to the power of negative 1. Yan. So, press equals, we have negative 4. Now, since this is numerically equal to this one, ibig sabihin, tama yung sagot natin. Now, tama to kasi ito yung nasa answer key. Now, pag walang answer key, dapat ikaw talaga yung magsasagot and then you can check your answer afterwards. But kung exam and then merong choices, then you can just use the given choices and then kung ano yung magtutugma, yan na yung sagot. So, madali lang talaga. Now, para ma-develop natin yung skill in doing this, let's try another equation. Ano ba yung merong answer key? Only odd numbers. So, what if itatry ko yung number 3? Ito. So, yung sagot must be this one. Yan. So, diba, our equations are not in the form of this one. Dapat ito yung equation. And then, yung solution naman must be C lang yung dapat na nasa kabilang side or nasa isang side. So, we must rearrange this. Now, for this problem, we can treat theta as x. Diba? Kasi, yan naman yung independent variable natin. So, we have here cos x dy. Ito. Then, diba, we must have the form na nakaset yan to 0. So, the term containing dx is this one. Kasi yung theta, tinreat ko as x. So, pag i-move ko yan sa kabilang side ng equation, it will be minus. So, minus y cosecant squared x na lang instead of theta, then dx plus cos x dy equal yan to 0. Yan. So, this is now in the form of the yung kailangan natin sa calculator technique. And then, the solution naman is this one. So, yung C dapat nasa isang side lang siya ng equation. So, we can move all of these sa left side. Therefore, C becomes ln y minus ln sec theta plus tan theta, then minus cosecant theta. Ito lang. Yan. So, diba, the term containing dx, yan yung u. And then, the term containing dy, yan yung v. So, u saka v. Yan. So we have diba u times negative u times v to the negative 1. So now pag i-try mo yan, ln, yung ln dyan, pag sinat mo to, anong tawag dito, sinat mo to 2 yung value ng x saka y, mag-error siya, magma-math error. So napapakita ko na lang for a while, ah. By the way pala, since this involves trigonometric functions, then dapat naka-radians yung calculator mo or naka-rad. So press mode, I mean ano pala, shift then mode to access setup, then press 4 para maging radians. Yan, so R na yan, and then we can now input this. So diba negative of u, u is negative y, negative recall y, multiplied by cosecant squared x. Now to type that sa calculator, we have 1 divided by sine, kasi reciprocal function yan ng sine, yung cosecant, then x, then naka-square yan, so we have to square this. Yan. And then multiply natin by v to the power of negative 1. So ano yung v, diba cos x, so cosine x to the negative 1. So press equals, we have this value, negative 5.81. So let me store this letter A. Ayan. And then diba after which kunin natin yung ddx sa solution ng differential equation. So ito yan, ito pala yung rearranged form na. So gagawin natin ddx, again ddx of the normal function muna. So copy lang natin to, and then papalitan ko na lang lahat ng theta by x para mas madaling intindihin. Yan. And then we have to set here kung ano yung value ng x saka y. Now since naka-store kanina x equals 2 saka y equals 2, yan din yan dito. So x equals 2, y equals 2. So ddx, ayan, then ln y alpha y tas minus ln, ano yung sec x? Sec x is the reciprocal function of cosine, so 1 divided by cos x dapat, then plus tangent x parenthesis, then minus cosecant x, magiging 1 over sine x. Ayan. And then x is equal to 2. Now press equals, magma-math error pag 2 yung ginamit natin. So ano yung workaround? Usually pag merong ln, ginagamit ko talaga is decimal. So try daw natin, instead of 2, gagamitan natin ng 0.5. Yan. But if 0.5 yan, then you have to modify this. I mean, ito ba? Yung negative uv to the negative 1. Kasi pag ito yung value ng x saka y, yan din yung isa-substitute natin sa equations u and v. So, ito yung mangyayari. Balik tayo dyan. Ito man yan, di ba? So, this is negative u, then multiplied by v to the negative 1. So, gagawin ko, press calc, and then I will set y to 0.5, and also x. So, 0.5 din yan. So, we have 2.478789. So, I will store this letter A. Ayan. So, nakastore na siya sa A. And then, input ko to. So, saan ba yan, ah? Naku, wala na. We have to input this ulit. So, shift ddx, then again ln y minus ln tas sec x, so 1 divided by cos x, then plus tangent x parenthesis, and then minus 1 divided by sine x. Ayan. Then x is equal to, ano yung ginamit natin? Diba 0.5. So this must also be 0.5. Ayan. So press equals. We have this value, 2.678. So I will store this. Wait lang. Ly minus ln. Yan, tama lang. So, shift store, ilalagay ko sa B. Yan. And then, papalitan natin lahat ng variables. Bala, ito pa rin. But lahat ng Y, papalitan natin ng X. So, ito, papalitan ng X. Itong dalawa, magiging Y. Then, ito naman, magiging Y din. So, just press up, and then, ito, ln x, then 1 over cos y plus tan y, and then minus 1 over sine y. Yan. Then, x equals 0.5 pa rin. So, press equals, we have this value, so 2. Yan. So, shift, store, and then lalagay natin yan sa C. So, again, gagawin natin, ito yung mag-a-act as U. Ito naman yung mag-a-act as V. So, diba, nakastore yan sa, ito nakastore sa B. Ito naman nakastore sa C. So, just recall B, then multiply natin, negative B, then multiplied by U, recall C, to the negative 1. So, to the negative 1. Yan. Now, naging negative 1.339. Hindi siya same sa letter A. Check down natin. Ah, okay. Sorry. Mali yung pagka-simplify ko. Kasi, pag i-move natin yung CSC sa left side ng equation natin, it will be positive. Sorry. Yan. So, this must be plus pala. Yan lang yung i-change natin. Itong nasa DDX. Hindi naman ma-affect yung U sa ka-V. So, konting modifications. Instead of minus, this is plus pala. Yan. And then, still x equals 0.5. Now, this corresponds to the first equation. Ito. So, press equals. We have this value pala. Minus 4.957. So, shift store. Lalagay ko sa B. Yan. Then, press up. Papalitan lang natin yung variables. Ito, magiging x. Ito naman, magiging y. So, y. Ito rin. Saka ito. Yan. So, still 0.5 equals 2 pa rin. So, shift, store, lagay ko sa C. So, again, we have B, negative B times C to the negative 1. It must be equal to this value. So, try down natin. Negative B times C to the negative 1. Press equals. We have 2.478. Now, if we compare natin yan sa A kanina, it's also 2.478. Therefore, tama yung solution natin. So, if this will appear sa exam nyo, and then this is one of the choices, then you can just use the choices to identify the correct answer. So, as your exercise, try to solve number, itong number 5. Try to solve it yourself, and then you can use any value for x and y. Yan, but pinakita ko lang na pwedeng 0.5, pwedeng kahit anong value yan. And then, ito lang talaga dapat yung form natin sa equations. Sige, sige.